Given the standard equation of a hyperbola, we want to graph and find the major components of the hyperbola. The first thing we need to recognize is that the form of the equation tells us whether we have a horizontal or vertical transverse axis. Notice in our equation, we have the x part of the equation minus the y part. So because the x part is first, or the x part is the positive fraction, we'll have a horizontal transverse axis, sometimes called the major axis. And that would be this axis here. Just to review, if the y part of the equation was first, and then we had minus the x part, we'd have a vertical transverse axis, and therefore the hyperbola would open up and down. But our equation fits this form, so the hyperbola will open left and right. Next, the center of the hyperbola will have coordinates h, k. So because we have the quantity x minus 2 squared, the x coordinate is going to be positive 2. And because we have the quantity y plus 1 squared, the y coordinate will be negative 1. So our center has coordinates 2, negative 1, which would be this point here. Next, the denominator of the first fraction, or what I think of as the positive fraction, is going to be a squared. So a squared equals 9. Then the denominator of the fraction that we're subtracting is b squared, so b squared equals 4. So we have a squared equals 9, so the positive value of a would be a equals 3, and b squared equals 4, so the positive value of b would be b equals 2. Knowing these two values help us find the vertices of the hyperbola as well as the endpoints of the conjugate axis. The vertices are also the endpoints of the transverse or major axis, and because we have a horizontal transverse axis, the endpoints or the vertices will be a units to the left and right of the center. And since a is equal to 3, one vertex will be 3 units to the left, or this point here. The other vertex would be 3 units to the right, or this point here. So looking at the coordinate plane, we can see the coordinates of the two vertices would be negative 1, negative 1, and 5, negative 1. We could have also found these by adding and subtracting 3 to the x-coordinate of the center. Notice 2 minus 3 is negative 1, 2 plus 3 is 5. Now let's come back to the foci. Let's find the endpoints of the conjugate axis. Well, this is the conjugate axis that has a length of 2 times b, and since the center is the midpoint, from the center if we go up and down b units, we'll find the two endpoints of the conjugate axis, which is also called the minor axis. And since b is equal to 2, if we go down 2 units, this would be one endpoint. If we go up 2 units, this would be the other endpoint of the conjugate axis. So again, looking at the coordinate plane, we can see the endpoints would have coordinates 2, negative 3, and 2, 1. Of course, we could also add and subtract 2 from the y-coordinate of the center to obtain these coordinates. Notice that negative 1 minus 2 is negative 3, negative 1 plus 2 is positive 1. Now that we have the endpoints of the transverse and conjugate axis, we're going to form a rectangle that will help us sketch the asymptotes of the hyperbola. We're going to form a rectangle so that these four black points will be the midpoints of each side, so the rectangle would look like this. Again, this is the transverse axis or major axis, and this would be the conjugate or minor axis. And the asymptotes of the hyperbola would contain the diagonals of this rectangle. So our two asymptotes would look like this, and look like this. So before we find the equation of the asymptotes though, let's go ahead and find the coordinates of the foci. And again, because we have a horizontal major axis, the two foci will be c units to the left and right of the center. But we don't have the value of c, we'll have to find it using the equation c squared equals a squared plus b squared, since we know a squared and b squared. So we would have c squared equals a squared or 9 plus b squared or 4, So c squared equals 13. We're only concerned about the positive value of c, so we'll take the principal square root. This isn't going to simplify. We're going to have c equals square root 13. But because we're going to use this value to plot points on the coordinate plane, we also want the decimal approximation. This is approximately 3.606. So going back to our graph, the two foci will be approximately 3.6 units to the right and left of the center. So starting at the center, if we go to the left, approximately 3.6 units would be about here. And 3.6 units to the right of the center would be approximately here. Notice how to find the exact coordinates of the foci. We would have to add and subtract square root of 13 to the x-coordinate of the center, because the foci are to the left and right of the center. So because the center has coordinates 2, negative 1, the focus on the left would have coordinates 2 minus square root 13, comma, negative 1. And the focus on the right would have coordinates 2 plus square root 13, comma, negative 1. And now for the last step, we're going to find the equations of the asymptotes. And since I'm not a big fan of memorizing formulas, we'll go ahead and use the graphs of our lines to find our equations. For example, if we consider the asymptotes, or these two lines here, notice how both lines contain the center, or contain the point 2, negative 1. So if we can find the slope of these lines, we can then use point-slope form of a line to find the equation. And this is another reason why this rectangle is very helpful. For example, if we consider again the center and this point here, we can determine the slope. We would go up b units and right a units, or up 2 units and right 3 units. Therefore, the slope of this line, we'll call it m sub 1, is equal to 2/3. Then looking at the other line, notice how we'd have to go down b units and right a units, or down 2 units and right 3 units. So the slope of the second asymptote, m sub 2, is equal to negative 2/3. So now we know the slopes of the lines, and we know that the lines both contain the point 2, negative 1. We can find the equations of our asymptotes. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So now using point-slope form of a line, where the point would be the center of the hyperbola that both lines contain, and we just found the slopes of the two asymptotes. The one equation of the asymptote would be y minus negative 1, or y plus 1, equals the slope 2/3 times the quantity x minus x sub 1, or x minus 2, which means the second equation would be y plus 1 equals negative 2/3 times the quantity x minus 2. Let's go ahead and clear the parentheses and solve for y so our equations are in slope-intercept form. So we'll have y plus 1 equals 2/3 x, 2/3 times negative 2, that'll be minus 4/3. And we'll go ahead and subtract 1 on both sides. Well, subtracting 1 is the same as subtracting 3/3. Negative 4/3 minus 3/3 is negative 7/3, so minus 7/3. Now for the second line, we'd have y plus 1 equals negative 2/3 x, plus 4/3. Again, subtract 1 on both sides. So we have y equals negative 2/3 x. This would be positive 4/3 minus 3/3, or 1/3. These would be the two equations of our asymptotes. Now let's finish by graphing our hyperbola. We know the hyperbola will contain each vertex and approach the asymptotes. So the graph of the hyperbola would look something like this, and like this. Okay, hope you found this explanation helpful.